with you. Thank you.
It was cool.
Are you reading that for a class?
Nah, I'm just reading it for fun.
Oh, gotcha. You don't mind me asking, what are you studying?
I'm a bio and chem double major. I'm on the pre-med track, but I've got minor in physics just for fun.
That's really neat. Do you like the track so far?
Yeah, it's alright. I don't know, I kind of wish I could change my major sometimes.
To what?
Anthropology. I don't know, it's just kind of cool how you get to learn a little bit about everything. But you can't really specialize in anything particular, so there's not really any money there.
Is that why you're studying medicine?
Now that I think about it, yeah. My parents have a lot invested in me because I'm an only child. You know, my parents went here, their parents went here, their parents went here. I don't know, I guess just kind of to continue the legacy.
And there's sort of this thing about myself that I need to figure out.
Cesare!
It's Cesare.
The psychiatrist is ready to see you.
Hey, Clea, wait up!
Hey, how are you? Okay, that's good. Are we gonna talk about what happened last night? Why'd you leave? I was gonna make you some maple pancakes.
I don't want your sin cakes!
What?
You don't get it, do you? I was saving myself.
Saving yourself for what?
For marriage!
Alright, y'all, it's time to step out of your minds and drop knowledge bombs on each other. It's group work, y'all. Group work. You guys, we're presenting your final projects to each other. Don't be afraid to critique one another. Alright, I'll be assigning you all. Clay and Bobby, you two will work together. Sarah and Paige, you two are working together. And Lewis and Playboy Girl, y'all will work together. And Chinelo and Josiah, you two will work together.
Do you want to present first, or...? I'll go first. So, I'm doing medicinal use in literature, particularly pre-raphaelite art in the sub-regions of Belgium. This area is prominent for... Are you even listening? I hate that.
Why do you even care? You're just doing this because people are watching.
What do you mean?
The only reason you're being nice with me is to validate yourself in front of everyone else. Not the only reason anyone's nice to anyone.
No, I don't know.
No, you don't know. Last week you couldn't stand to talk to me, and now you want to be my best fucking friend? I could disappear. I'm not Carol. You can't call on me to solve your fucking problems. I could disappear tonight and you wouldn't even notice.
So, when you set up for yesterday, you didn't care at all? You said it for the hell of it?
Yeah, why would I give a shit about you?
So is it okay if I present first?
Proceed.
I decided to do my project on love in the Bible. I know it's not the perfect example of literature, but I feel it's so appropriate as to how I feel. Romans 12:9, Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good.
Jude 1:7. In a similar way, Sodom and Gomorrah and the surrounding towns gave themselves up to sexual perversion and immorality. They serve as an example of those who suffer the punishment of eternal fire.
1 Peter 4:8. Above all, love each other deeply, because love covers over a multitude of sins.
Revelation 21:8. But the cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral will be in the fiery lake of burning sulfur. This is the second death.
Probably 7:7. Shit was real.
Hey, I'm so sorry I'm late. I had an appointment that ran a little over and...
Shh. You were where you needed to be, when you needed to be there. Now you're here, and that's beautiful.
Oh, hey, sit right here. Yeah. Hey, yeah.
Hey. Oh my God, this is like the weirdest class I have like ever taken.
And it's only gonna get weirder.
What's up?
I think we need to talk about some stuff.
I'd agree with that.
You've been missing a lot of class lately. Is everything okay?
It wasn't, but it's getting better. I went to campus health today and saw one of the clinical psychologists. When we started talking, I realized that a lot of the stuff that's been bothering me relates back to my relationship with Xavier. I probably should have told you he was my boyfriend in Quebec.
Was he abusive or something?
Oh, no. He was awesome. He's such a great guy. He wasn't the problem. It was me. Through my relationship with him, I realized I wasn't happy with who I was. I finally got the courage to tell my parents what I was feeling, and they didn't like what I had to say. They gave me the option to either get my shit together or get out. I got out and transferred here.
Well, why weren't you honest about this before?
It all happened so quickly. I wanted to start a new life, and I didn't want any remnants of the past. That's why I didn't tell Xavier I was leaving. He came down to make sure that I was okay. I only ever told my brother.
Yeah. I lost my virginity last night to Bobby.
What? Are you okay?
Honestly, I kinda liked it, and that's the problem.
What's the problem?
I'm not gonna lie, I kinda feel like I might get struck by lightning. I mean, my church taught me that...
Wait. Your church or you? What do you believe?
That's a good question. Wait, I'm totally sorry, I cut you off what you were saying before.
Oh, no, it's fine, really.
No, it's not. Your problems are just as important as mine. You can talk to me.
I don't know exactly how to say this, but I'm not okay with being a girl.
You know, it's okay to not be okay.
Isn't that a quote by Kristen Stewart?
It is. And I'm not ashamed of it. I've been spending a lot of time on Tumblr doing research.
Research?
Research.
I see. Are you going to get that?
Oh no, it's fine. We're having a great conversation.
I don't see any lightning. Do you hear any thunder?
I know this doesn't make any sense to you, but this is just something that's been ingrained in me.
No, I totally get it. It's kind of the same thing with me. What I have been has been ingrained in me too. Fuck society. Bobby! So great to hear from you. Oh, you want to talk to Clea? On her phone? Sounds reasonable. There's a sad boy in dire need of your services. Can you help him out?
Hey, wait, what? You're outside?
Wait. Safe sex is great sex.
Thanks, I'll be back later, maybe.
I wanted to give you back your necklace. I fixed it for you.
Thanks. You didn't have to do that.
No, it seems to mean a lot to you. You're always holding it when you get nervous.
You notice that?
I notice everything about you.
I'm sorry I freaked out on you this morning.
No, you don't have to apologize. I don't understand it, but it's okay.
I don't really understand it either.
I've never done this before.
Done what?
Never done this before.
I haven't either.
Isolation is not a permanent state, but how do we transition from isolation to finding connection? To be honest, I have no idea. We're all individuals. Whether we are able to identify ourselves and our problems doesn't make us weak or strong. Sometimes you gotta lean on other people and talk about these problems you have. Sometimes that's really hard to do, but that just makes you human.
Hey, great show tonight as always.
Thanks so much.
Your voice sounds so different on the radio than in person.
Yeah, that's my philosophical voice. Gotta keep the audience interested. Watching the whites of your eyes turn red. The calendar on your wall is ticking. The days off you've been reading some
old. I can disappear tonight. How much you've changed. All the money in the world. I could disappear. Back those days. You pull back your curtains and the sun. You watch a plane flying across a clear blue sky.